queens wind down. The queens wind down. Hey, hey. The queens wind down.
Hey, hey. Me and my girls the just winding down. Wind down. Talking this and that while we're fixing each other's crowns.
Everybody don't know you call me Tyra, right?
That's a little thing.
I know. Say hey to everybody out there in cyber world.
Hello to everyone. Welcome back to those that were here last week. And we are so glad to have some meaningful and open conversation.
Well, listen, let's see, because I had to make sure. Okay. I had to make sure we were good.
I'll be good.
We had some great conversation last week.
We always have great conversations.
I am so excited to have you back.
I am too. You're looking all sparkly.
Thank you. So, yes, I am looking sparkly. I don't know if they can see, but I am wearing my True Diva Designs. My girl, shout out to
that
my girl, Veronica
really nice.
Limscombe, who just won Designer of the Year.
Oh,
yay!
Bravo. Any award.
Right.
Bravo, to a phenomenal queen. Yeah,
a black woman.
That's what's up. That's
you know, we be so caught up in name brands, yeah, Gucci,
all that.
Louis. But shout out to all of the African American designers, True Diva Designs.
That's
yep,
right.
I'm wearing my glitter girl leggings.
She's an inspiration to all those out there trying to get into the industry.
Yeah.
Those look really nice, though.
Thank you. So, you see your cocktail?
I tasted it.
You tasted it already?
Delicious. They saw me.
Where was I at when you tasted it?
Girl, I snuck it in.
You snuck it in?
I snuck it in.
You came on set and snuck everything in?
Snuck a taste. Like, that looks so good. I looked around to see where the bartender was.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, yeah. I did that, so you know. I kind of grew up in a bar. You know, the Red Shingles. Shout out to the Red Shingles in Port Huron, Michigan. If you read any of Terry McMillan's books, she calls it the Red Tavern.
Right.
So my daddy would come and get me for his visitations on the weekend.
Okay.
Right? And take me to the bar. So I would sit at the bar as a kid.
Oh, okay.
And just watch them make drinks. And then I started performing on stage.
Okay.
And I would make them pay me. So like at 5 or 6 years old, I was singing Dr. Feelgood and didn't know what the hell I was talking about.
Right, you just know the money
but
was coming.
But now I know what Dr. Feelgood is.
Right. I tell you what, back in those days, that's when that whole is almost like friends. Everybody's family. So you're there amongst family.
Right.
You know?
And just, you know, I was just talking about this. Back in the day, I used to could go to the store, cop my grandmother's snuff, her beer.
Snuff.
Yeah, she used to dip snuff and have a spit cup. Shout out to my big mama. I miss my big mama. Or even, you know, cigarettes and stuff. We had to be like 5 or 6.
Right.
Now, you better not send your children in the store to cop anything that the government has deemed illegal.
What? Anything at all?
Right.
You know, they're going to come back with a worker.
So real quick, let's see who we got. Let's see who we got.
Who's watching?
So listen, we have Kanisha, Khadijah, Brian. Hey, y'all. We have Natasha. We have Jacksonville, Florida in the house.
Okay.
We have Stanley, Memphis, Tennessee. Valerie, I think Valerie is in Virginia. Deacon the DJ, TJ, Deacon the DJ, my brother, who I went to Vegas with.
Okay,
they're in Jacksonville.
Okay.
I'm Sean Crowdy. Hey, King. Hey, Dwayne Bogan. Hi. Raheem Davis in New York.
I'm glad we
Tina
got some Singleton, gentlemen in the house.
Lena Malone.
The twist is in the
house. Yes,
the twist is in the house. So, we got a lot to talk about.
So real quick, because everybody might not know what the twist is before we introduce the drink and before
explain,
we start indulging. So the Queen's
the
Wind Down is done this season with a twist, and the twist is the King. Last season, we had it where the Queens, we chopped it up about everything. My Kings kind of got offended. And so they wanted to be a part of the conversation. So this season, you will see different kings from different avenues, different walks of life, co-hosting with me, and different queens as well, co-hosting with me and just chopping it up about everything that you go through. Because y'all know my motto, if you're dealing with it,
We're talking about it.
We are.
And you need to talk about it.
Yeah.
Don't go through by yourself. Other people are going through.
Well. So and they're watching you.
That's right.
I got to pull up my little pant real quick.
And we're family, so you can tell us anything, and we're going to tell you exactly how we feel.
So, Derek, you see your fruit?
I do.
Because we talking SEX tonight.
What?
Sex. Let's talk about sex, baby.
Grown people stuff.
But real quick, because I love making cocktails.
Yes.
This is made, because we're in fall, I love apple cider. I really, really love warm apple cider.
Yeah.
I love apple cider donuts. Yeah. I don't like pumpkin anything. Don't give me a pumpkin donut, a pumpkin
No pumpkin
pie.
No pumpkin
no!
pie.
Sweet potato pie.
No pumpkin pie.
I'm all black. Sweet potato pie. Keep that pumpkin pie over
there. Have you ever had any good pumpkin pie?
No.
Never.
I'm black.
If anybody out there has ever had some good pumpkin pie, please let us know, because I've been taking like a slight soft survey, and nobody's ever had any good pumpkin pie.
Well, look where it resonated from. No shade, but you know, they really don't season. So when you get the sweet potato pie, you got your molasses, your nutmeg, don't give me no pumpkin pie, Derek.
All right, okay.
I'm black. Okay. Keep that over there.
All right.
Thank you.
I want some good pie.
So apple cider. This is made with apple cider.
Okay.
And for those of you that know me, know that my taste buds is very, very expensive. So I like drinking good liquor.
Liquor.
You see my liquor.
Liquor.
You see the lips liquor. Yes. Hennessy, Louis. This is a dope whiskey. Woodford Reserved. They did not pay me to advertise, but because I love it, it is a bourbon whiskey. So you get two in one.
Okay.
Right?
And we call that some good dark. That's some good dark.
Good dark. Good dark. Right and there. So for me, I like it better than, it's more smoother than Jack Daniels.
Okay.
Right? Because I know some people like to put Jack Daniels, woo woo. Yeah.
My granddaddy was a Jack Daniels
right.
man.
My mother in love is a Jack Daniels woman. Mm-hmm. Right? So, yeah, this is Woodford Reserve. So, I took some of that, mixed it with some apple cider.
Okay.
And cut up some apples. And you tasted yours already?
I did. It's delicious.
Well, let's toast episode of the Queen's Wine Down.
Yes, this episode.
Yeah.
You're going to need a drink for this one. All right. Okay.
Oh my gosh, it's so delicious.
I warned you.
It is so delicious. So real quick.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot to talk about.
We do.
But before we get into everything, you know I like to make sure everything is good.
Yeah. Are we good?
Yeah. Well, it says it's an error loading. But I think we're good. We should be good.
We better be good.
Right, we should be really, really, really good.
Have we not? Let us know. So
I know, let us
y'all
know.
Y'all are not hearing us.
Right. Are you not seeing us? Are you
or
not
if you are.
Hearing us? What's going on? Are we good?
Are we good?
So, Derek, real quick, Byron Allen versus Comcast.
So, behind the scenes, something that we did not know about, I didn't know about it until I saw it pop on my timeline, was his conversation about him being in a legal battle with Comcast over programming, money, and all those sorts.
Okay. So when you say a legal battle,
yes,
I need for you to go into detail.
So he is suing Comcast over rights to air his productions.
Okay.
They have held back airing his productions for reasons that no one knows. He doesn't know. No one knows. And the amount of funding and airtime that's given to African-American producers and African-Americans in general is, I forget the number that he said, but it's extremely low. Let's say it's 6% of the total amount of funding and airtime given out.
Okay.
That's all they allow us.
Okay.
Or give us. So he had an issue with that, and, you know, President Obama had asked him about what was going on with it, and he told him the truth. You know, he said, and what the one statement that struck me in the interview was, you know, do you want the Hollywood answer or do you want the real answer? Uh-huh. President Obama said, you know, give me the real answer. And he told him, like, these people are, you know, being biased and racist, and they're discriminating against us, and they will not allow me to do, you know, to air my stuff and to get my appropriate, you know, allotted time and things of that nature. So he went on to sue them. You know, he spoke to Obama, and he actually came with, the only way that I'm going to get something done is I have to sue them. Because they actually, for what he's saying, is told him, like, for everybody else, they actually air the show or allow them to do whatever, then they come back to the table.
Right.
They won't even allow him to do that. They want him to come to the table first. And he said that wasn't...
So let's be extremely clear. He went up against two major media entities.
Giants. Charter
and Comcast. And
Comcast, if you look up... I don't know everything that they own, but if you look up, they own a lot.
Right.
Like... I can't even, I mean, it's so much stuff. You'd be like, Comcast owns that? Like, let's say, for example, like Disney or something. Like, they own, like, huge things.
Huge things.
And you'll be amazed. Like, you'd be like, Comcast owns it? So there's some almost.
But here's the thing. He lost the trial to Comcast. And won the trial with Charter.
Right.
But he took both of them.
He said, I'm not going to take one without the other.
Charter appealed.
Yep.
And he appealed his loss with Comcast. And in the appeal of both, the courts decided with him.
Yes.
So this is how it got to the Supreme Court.
And so now they're taking it to the Supreme Court. He wasn't going to take it to the Supreme Court. They decided to take it to the Supreme Court.
Okay.
And given the administration, he's kind of in fear that it will still end up going the other way. Even though his appeal, he actually won in one of the most important circuits. The same circuit, I do believe, that's going to...
So, by it going to the Supreme Court, the threat now is the administration for number 45, Barr, is actually speaking on behalf of Comcast.
Right?
Right. And so, the threat of... the whole entire situation is something that was granted to us, we African Americans, people of color. Mm-hmm. And so if...
Oh.
Go ahead.
I'm recalling some of his conversation now.
Okay.
He said they are going all the way back to a law or a constitutional right. Back in like
1861,
something,
I think it
or
is.
63, something 63. Really crazy,
right?
That spoke where about what we're states, allowed to have and what we're not allowed
what
to have.
What it states is that as free African Americans, black people, or slaves, we are equal, we are able, to compete for jobs, compete for contracts,
all that.
And all of this. If the Supreme Court rules against him. What it does is it makes it extremely hard for people of color to file suit against discriminatory lawsuits.
Exactly. So they basically will be changing that law by actually going against his court case. And that will be, like, detrimental for us.
So
detrimental for people in general.
What do we need to do as a community?
We need to rally behind them, rally behind any cause that is for equality.
I can't stand Comcast. Comcast is the only network, internet provider out there in the country where I live.
And they're really the only one here.
And I hate them.
Yeah.
Right? I think they're extremely high.
They are.
But yeah, for me, it's a no-brainer. So I wouldn't have a problem with boycotting Comcast if I had to.
Absolutely.
And then I need for you to contact the Congressional Black Caucus.
Absolutely.
Because it's some representatives that have not signed off on it. And I'm going to go through Derek.
Yeah.
I want to talk while I'm finding this information about all of the black or African American Congressional Black Caucus leaders who haven't signed on with him to support him. I want you to talk about his statement that he made about President Obama.
So apparently he made a statement about President Obama was he in his oppression of a white president in blackface. I did not hear the statement. I read it. So I don't want to.
So basically he's saying that President Obama, like many African-Americans,
thought,
feel
absolutely.
That President Obama did nothing for the African-American community.
Right. And what, you know, in my opinion, what you have to understand is, you know, President Obama, first of all, he's of mixed heritage.
Right.
He's white and black. He's just an equal person. He's not going to do more for what he did. More for white people than he did for black people. More mm-hmm. for black people than he did for white people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he just wants everyone to succeed. And I don't have a problem with that. Mm-hmm. Like, if you have a problem with that, then you have a problem, period. Like, mm-hmm. there are African-American racists. There are people that are black people that are racist. The thing is, we
black
all need the same opportunities.
Black people can't be racist.
Why?
Because we can't be.
Why?
Why? How is it that we're racist?
How can you say? Explain. No. You said black people
black
cannot
people
be racist.
Black people can't be racist. No, we're
okay,
not
why?
Racist. We just
we may not be racist, no. But can we be racist?
We probably can.
Okay. That's all you that we're done. We probably can.
But
okay.
For the most majority.
For the majority, we're not.
We're not.
Because what we're trying people to do is have empathy about what's going on with us.
But I said
so they call us racist because we're actually for ourselves. Like we are
because
advocates.
We're pro-black.
We're pro-black. And
it
that doesn't
mean
make us
that
racist.
We're racist.
Exactly.
But
and if you're pro-white, that doesn't make you racist either. But it all depends on how you treat other people.
And I agree with you
right?
Because I had a conversation the other day and I was laughing, and maybe I shouldn't have been laughing, but I'm silly most times, at my big mama because yeah. She would say stuff because she grew up in the South and she watched them go in houses and snatch up black men and lynch them. So they would be like blue-eyed devils and things of that nature.
Mm.
And so I thought about that because we say that racism is taught, right?
Yes.
And although we heard her say these things, we heard it often, it did not turn us into racists like it does other ethnicities.
Yeah.
Some of my best friends growing up in Port Huron, Michigan was white. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I went to an all-white school. Right. Michigami, shout out. I just posted that picture a few months ago. But I get tickled because when we look at the other race
yeah.
Or different ethnicities, they're generational racists.
Yeah.
And even though we grew up around my grandmother or even excuse me, other different African-Americans who grew up in that era, who may feel some type of way
absolutely.
About that race. We didn't turn out that way. We were taught to love everybody, to literally judge a person by the content of their character and not by the color of their skin.
Absolutely.
And
that
so,
is such a
let
great
me read
statement.
Well, Dr. King, shout out to
I
Dr.
Know,
King
shout
for
out to
that.
Dr. King.
Rest in peace. Let me read the names of, it's the Civil Rights Act of 1866.
They're taking this
yes.
all the way back to
1866. And these
like,
are the Congressional Black Caucus members in your state that have not, that have yet to sign the petition to stand with him.
Put
and
him
we're
blast.
Calling our names.
Put them on blast.
Alma Adams, North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Holland, Allred, Texas.
Texas.
Sanford Bishop, Georgia.
Georgia. We're still
Lisa
in the South.
Blunt, Rochester, Delaware.
Rochester. First state.
Delaware. Anthony Brown, Maryland.
Shut up.
No. Anthony Brown, Maryland.
Oh.
G.K. Butterfield, North Carolina. Andre Carson, Indiana. William Lacey Clay, Jr., Missouri. Jim Clyburn, South Carolina. Danny Davis, Illinois. Antonio Delgado, New York. Val Demings, Florida. Dwight Evans, Pennsylvania. Marcia Fudge, Ohio, Al Green, Texas, Alcee Hastings, Florida, Johanna Hayes, Connecticut, Stephen Horsford, Nevada,
okay.
Hakeem Jeffries, New York, Eddie
over.
Bernice Johnson, Texas, Hank Johnson, Georgia, Robin Kelly, Illinois, Brenda Lawrence, Michigan, Al Lawson, Florida, Sheila Jackson Lee, Texas, Lucy McBath, Georgia, Donald McEachin, Virginia, Gregory Meeks, New York, Gwen Moore, Wisconsin, Joe Nagels, Colorado, Eleanor Holmes, Norton, D.C., Stacy Plaskett, Virgin Islands, Cedric Richmond, Louisiana, Bobby Rush, Illinois, David Scott, Georgia, Terry Sewell, Alabama, Benny Thompson, Mississippi, Lauren Underwood, Illinois, Mark Veazey, Texas, Fredica Wilson, Florida. These are all of your Congressional Black Caucus leaders that have yet to sign on to support Brian Allen's Supreme Court case. They rule on it next Wednesday, I think. No, the 13th. Whichever day November the 13th is, make sure you get in the know, contact your Congressional Black Caucus leaders and ask them why, and so, tell them that you would like for them to support.
And so we want this to be a movement. The reason why it's a movement is because this is about the basic foundation of equality. The we're going back to 1860 what?
66.
The basic foundation of what A should get, B should be entitled to. Not entitled to,
right,
but able to get as well.
Right.
It's simple. It doesn't have to be black or white, white or black, gray, female, male, the basics. What that person is available to that person should be available to that person. It's very simple. We can always talk amounts, percentages, who should get what, how many amount dollars. We can all discuss that. We can debate that all day long. If you don't care about equality, then don't call your Congressional Black Caucus member. And we'll see where it goes.
Right. And then it's that fear. I want to say this before we move on to the next subject at hand. It's the fear thereof. Yes. Oh, how dare he? Who is he? He can't speak for me. Let me tell y'all something. Stand for something or fall for any freaking thing.
That's right.
It's time out for being passive. Ooh. Okay? And we're seeing it. This is why Tyler Perry did what he did. The Tyler Perrys in our community matter. The Byron Allens in our community matters. You get what I'm saying? You matter within the community, so let your voice be heard. So next on the agenda.
Next on the agenda.
We're talking elections. Oh. Shout out to Virginia.
Shout out to Virginia.
Mm-hmm. I'll drink to that. If you don't know, Virginia has taken, been taken over by Blue.
I believe.
The Democrats have...
First time in 20, 25 years?
Something of that nature. Yeah.
And Virginia, you needed it. I mean, let's be
you
real.
So petty.
No, they did. That Commonwealth, they down there frying. But you know what? I'm going to leave that alone.
I'm going to leave that alone.
Anybody that has ever dealt with Virginia knows. You know. Especially those of color. That's all I'm saying. If you ever, and I'm telling you from... I've had issues in Virginia in 84. And I know people that have issues in Virginia right
now.
I
don't even like riding through Virginia.
Okay.
Let me tell y'all something.
Okay. You want some stories?
Give me one Virginia story.
One Virginia story. I'm in the Marine Corps.
Okay.
I'm in Camden Station in Camden, North Carolina. So I come home every weekend.
Every weekend.
Every 6 hours. Boom, in my little Escort GT. I'm coming through Virginia. I get stopped. I get a speeding ticket. I'm a Marine.
You don't give service people tickets.
Right, but we going to let him do his job. Mm-hmm. Okay, I get the ticket. So I got to come back to Virginia because the ticket is like 30 miles over the limit.
Uh-huh.
Right? I was doing like
90. You was reckless driving.
But it was a lot. It's a lot of us. At the time, and anybody that ever been to Campbell's Unit that went north, we call it swooping. So everybody that went north left at the same time on Friday. And so as we're going down the highway, everybody's chirping off. So if you're from Richmond, you turn off of Richmond. But you got literally 30 cars doing 90 miles an hour.
I was showing out.
Absolutely. We're young. We're service members. We're trying to get home.
Okay.
Right? So we're hauling. I come through Virginia. I get stopped to get a ticket. I come to court. This is my first ticket in Virginia. And I'm in the Marine Corps. Let's make this straight. Because I'm telling you, if you're in the service and you do something, they give you a little leeway, and you should, right? Mm-hmm. You're actually putting your life on the line for the country.
Right.
So you should get a little leeway, a little favoritism.
Maybe.
I go to court. The judge says, son, if I see you come through this county one more time, I'm going to lock you up. And I don't care if you're Marine. If I catch you speeding one, if you get a ticket... 1 mile over the speed limit in the state of Virginia and I see your name, I'm going to lock you up. I said, well, goddamn, it's a speed ticket. I didn't kill anybody. So I had to go through Virginia. You know, I'm get to Maryland.
Everybody else peeling off.
Now I got the back off. I can't even enjoy my ride now because I don't want to. Now, was it because of my skin color? I don't know. Probably, it could have been because I was 30 miles, but what I'm telling you.
But you was driving reckless. And as a service person.
I shouldn't be driving reckless. So I'm going to say he was doing his job. But what I'm telling you, there are other people that I know that have went to Virginia and had issues. And the punishment did not fit the crime.
It never does when it's us.
It did not fit the crime. It really did not fit the crime. And we've seen it many times in Virginia. And thank goodness now it has been taken over by blue.
Hey, so the next celebration was Kentucky.
Oh.
Kentucky, the blue took over the KY.
What?
Just the good old boys.
That's what I'm saying.
Never meaning no harm.
Kentucky.
Shout out to Kentucky. You know, I grew up in Kentucky, the bluegrass state.
The bluegrass state.
That's what's up. Mm. So shout out to Kentucky. So there was also
blue blood
elections in other states like Michigan. And before we go any further, I need to say this to my girl, my friend, my Shiro, Mayor Dr. Karen Weaver. I absolutely love you, Queen. You did that. And don't let nobody take that away from you. To the city of Flint, I wish you well. I love you. And I need to say this to you. It does not matter who your leader is.
Say it.
What matters is that you show up.
Say it.
You have to show up.
That's right.
If you want your city to be vibrant, if you want your city that I love, to thrive again, you have to show up.
That's right.
And you did not show up. Less than 15,000 people voted yesterday out of 90,000 residents.
That's terrible.
And I have a problem with that.
That's terrible. And then we get the percentages. So you're talking about 15,000 total.
Yeah.
And now we get the percentages. It's probably a horrible number, even more horrible.
I want us as a people, not just in Flint, but everywhere, to show
you
up.
Have to.
How dare you
don't
dishonor
complain.
And disrespect
it doesn't
matter
who you the
are. Don't
blood complain
that
you're not
was voting. Shed that for your right to vote.
It's incredible. And you're going to complain. You're going to complain about the water. You're going to complain about the federal government is not doing enough.
Right. So shout out to Sheldon Neely. Yeah. May he lead the city. And, you know, the people have spoken. We the people, you know, the people have spoken. And sometimes you have to give the people what they want.
That's right.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
And so I wish you all the best.
Right.
And again, to my girl, Mayor Karen Weaver, you did that, Queen. I absolutely love you. And you are my Shiro.
They going to need you before you need them.
I knew you. You're so petty.
I am petty. Girl, listen to me. They going to need you.
Real quick, Derek. I want to talk about, because we talked about Byron Allen versus Comcast.
Yes.
But I kind of skipped over something. The movies. Why people are boycotting Harriet.
Yeah, well, from what I hear.
Uh-huh.
Word on the street is that the movie focuses more on a relationship between a slave owner and a slave. So they're saying that the movie's focus was the relationship between Harriet Tubman's owner's son, who chased her through the whole movie. It wasn't really a movie that delved into the actual Underground Railroad, which would have shown more
diversity and truth and history.
And, yes, a historic thing.
Uh-huh.
And so people are upset about that.
Okay.
Because, number one, of her historical importance, right?
Mm-hmm.
And number two, just how things in Hollywood, you know, similar to what Byron, just how things in Hollywood go. Like,
well,
you know, the person writing the check.
I said that to say this. I saw so many mixed reviews. I have yet to go see it.
I have yet
because
to
of the Comcast situation.
Yeah,
Comcast is one of the, what is it, executive producer, what is it, production companies.
That work with.
They're connected to Harriet. And so, y'all know how I am. I boycott in a minute. I don't have a problem with boycotting anything.
It's hard. It's going to be hard for us to actually boycott.
Well, I want to read something that one of my sister girls, who is a Hollywood movie director, producer, and actress. You've probably seen her on BT, and I'm going to read something because her and I had a conversation, and I think it's worth reading. But I have yet to go see it, but the critics are saying it's just like Tyler Perry writing a Jewish movie on the Holocaust.
Right.
And so when I read that, I kind of knew something was off about it. Like, what they didn't depict the history of who Harriet Tubman really was.
Not really.
Okay, so let me read this from my sister girl, Jamie.
Yeah.
And I love Jamie. Jamie Burden O'Hare is one of the dopest. We went to middle school and high school together. She is a film director, screenwriter, and actress. You probably seen her on BET, TV One. She's just that girl. She's just a woman, a Renaissance woman.
Can she teach me how to write music?
And so you always want to know how to write music and sing. But this is what Jamie says. She says, so let me say what I have to say. Harriet is a hero. How dare some demean her to just a slave? The screenplay is written by two African-American writers, directed by an African-American woman, starring all African-American actors, minus the lead, who is African. I get the issue with Brits playing us in films, but for me, it's never an issue when they, excuse me, rip that shit. The way Forrest Whitaker ripped Idi Amin, but I digress. I didn't like 12 Years a Slave. For me, it lacked African-American nonsense. That took me out of the story, but that is not the case in this film. For the one black man that is a villain, not the main villain, there are 10 black men that are not villains in this film. Main point is Harriet is a hero, brilliant and brave. I want to see all my heroes, including Nat Turner in Birth of a Nation, on screen. Perhaps folks don't know the depths of history. Why else would someone diminish Harriet to just being a slave? One more thing. There are fictionalized characters that represent systems and people in narratives. Miss me with the film having to be exact. Did you say that about Malcolm X? Mm. As for the Comcast boycott, if that's how you feel, don't watch Black Klansmen, Talk to Me, I Am Ali, or Deliver Us from Eva, or watch NBC, because those are focus features and Comcast acquisitions too.
See,
great work. I got tongue tied.
They own a lot.
So Jamie had a great point.
She did.
And she kind of got on me. She was like, sis, do yourself a favor. Go see it. So the jury is still out on it. I'm still praying. God ain't said nothing yet. And I'll figure it out. So I went to go see Black and Blue.
Oh, did you like it? Did you hear the statement by Tyrese?
What did Tyrese say?
Snitches versus whistleblowers?
Yes.
What do you think
about
that?
Yes. Okay, that is some truth. Because you know how we talked about the snitching thing the snitching definition. What the definition of a snitch is on the Tyra Hill Show.
That's right.
And so often I've said that a snitch is not a resident, a law-abiding citizen who witnessed a crime and does their due diligence as a citizen and help the police out.
That's right.
You're not snitching.
A snitch is,
if Derek and I leave set right now, we go rob a bank, hit a lick, Derek get caught, he tell on me.
Why I got to tell?
He snitching. He a certified snitch. He a snitch.
That makes you a certified.
A certified snitch.
Certified. We're going to send you a certificate.
There is a difference between snitching and doing your citizen, your civil citizen duty.
That's right.
And reporting crime.
Every citizen's duty.
Right.
If you're not a part of the crime, is to say something. Because if you don't say something, when something happens to you and nobody says something,
or somebody
you love, don't complain. All right, moving on.
So I went to go see Black and Blue. It was slow for me.
Yeah.
However, you know I love girl power.
Yes.
I love the fact that she was in the service.
Yeah.
I hate the fact that her mom died and she had to come back to New Orleans. I love the fact that they depicted the corruption in New Orleans after Katrina.
Mm.
Right? I love the fact that for her, it was no gray area. It was right or wrong.
Right or wrong.
Just because you're the police, you don't get to murder somebody in cold blood.
Absolutely.
But and so for me,
where the film goes really left for me is this. Mm-hmm. And this, and we're the segment that we spoke about briefly. Mm-hmm. That I want to do is, you know, how far would you go, right? How far would you go?
Right.
And that's a lot of different. We're gonna apply that to a lot of different things in life. Mm-hmm. How far? What you're gonna hear are some people are gonna say they're gonna go far mm-hmm. for certain things, mm-hmm. like their kids, you know, and they're not gonna go far for certain things. And what I say is, you know, there's a, you know, a lot of them are gonna be lying, and the truth is somewhere between, mm-hmm. somewhere behind them. But we're gonna figure that out as we talk to our viewers. But the key to it is this. Not only was she doing what a whistleblower did, you see something wrong, you say something.
Absolutely.
The dude tried to kill her.
He tried. Well,
so what am I going to do now? What am I supposed to protect y'all now? Really? Right. Am I really supposed to protect y'all now when you actually tried to kill me? No, I'm not. You got me all the way twisted.
Now, I get frustrated in movies because, you know, I'm gangster.
Right.
In real life.
They don't really know it.
Right, in real life. So when I'm watching movies and people do dumb stuff, it irritates me. I'll be like, what the fuck you do that for?
Don't do that.
Right, like, girl, bye.
Right.
Right, like when she dropped her gun and then she was looking for it, like, girl, come on.
Yeah, what are you
You know
doing?
What I'm saying? And then you just walked over three guns. Like, why you didn't
pick one up?
Right, so, you know, boom, whatever.
That movie magic.
But for me, I love the fact that she stood against her brothers and sisters in blue and did the right thing. But it also depicted the corruption that we have in America within our law enforcement agencies.
Absolutely.
We just went through something in Baltimore.
I mean, I say this all the time, and a lot of my police officer friends, and I understand the force and what they go through, and I applaud them for being able to do that day in and day out. Mm-hmm. You do put your life online, but this is my issue. I'm tired of hearing one bad app. This is one bad. Every time something happens with a police officer, mm-hmm. they say, oh, the Gun Trace Task Force, they were just one bad apple
of the police department.
Of the police department that was rogue. But everybody else is okay.
No.
That's just a damn lie.
Getting cancer and it's just one cell.
That's a lie.
Eventually it's going to spread.
That cancer is 50-50.
And become deadly.
It's 50. It's more than 50-50.
Right.
Because most police officers benefit mm-hmm. and their families benefit mm-hmm. not only financially. Mm-hmm. I'm just talking about in a sort of local celebrity type of way. You mm-hmm. benefit from being a police officer. And you don't want to lose that benefit or jeopardize that benefit against going against your brothers. And it is a fraternity. Right? So you're not going to say. But my thing is, if you know a police officer is doing something wrong, you need to say something.
Right.
Same thing you ask of your citizens.
Right.
We would ask of you.
Right.
You are working with a dude.
You cannot come in the hood and ask us to snitch.
And you won't snitch.
Snitch. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Don't do it.
Right.
Don't do it.
And you have police officers that's planting narcotics.
Exactly.
You have police officers
and you know
that's
them. Y'all hear
guns.
About it. Y'all
and
hear about
when
it.
And when something happened within the community, you want to come in and say, well, nobody want to talk, nobody snitching. Y'all have the same code of conduct
the
blue.
Come on now. That's the basics to it.
Right.
You know, and if you don't say what's going on, that culture starts to grow. It grows because that group, they know each other, they work together, so forth and so on. So corruption is terrible in the police force. And until you guys say, the good ones, and it's a lot of you out there, until you say something and start to stand up to the bad ones, regardless of what's going to happen, be a true whistleblower, we're going to have this problem. And you know who these police officers are. You know who they are.
I have to say this, and we have to move on because time is moving so fast.
I told you
and
we
have
to be 2 hours.
Stop trying to get us at 2 hours.
All right.
Shame on number 45 in his administration for trying to bully the whistleblower. Like, really, you're really, really, really inciting violence from the White House because we all know what happened to snitches. You get what I'm saying? So shame on you if you have not been briefed on that. Just Google the whistleblower, number 45, because I just don't want to spend no more damn time talking about his ugly orange ass.
I don't.
We're talking about police officers, something went down in Bossier, honey, in Louisiana, right up the street from my mama.
What?
I need my my mama to move here close to me. I got to keep an eye on Bert. And she said, oh, he likes saying my name.
That's my babe.
We might call her today in the show. But listen, so in Bossier City, Louisiana, there was a police officer who got a call from a hotel. And when he arrived with a Caucasian woman with scissors in her hand. And so...
I think I heard that encounter. And he asked her to drop and she lunged.
She verbally assaulted him. She called him the N-word several times.
I did hear that.
She told him that if he wanted her to put the scissors down, that he would have to shoot her. And I'm going to let you guys hear the clip. Yeah. Courtesy of of News One, and right here, this is the clip, and this happened again in Bossier City, Louisiana, and it's just spinning. But basically, she just called him a lot of the N words. But here we go, right here.
You got a white female here.
Hey, if you come over here, I will kill you. Drop the scissors. Drop the scissors.
Man, put those scissors down.
Put those scissors down.
No, you're not going
to
shoot me. You're not
going
to shoot me. You're
going to
have to shoot me.
Put those scissors down. Hey, put those scissors down.
You're going to have to shoot me.
Put those
See how aggressive she is.
You got a white female kid.
You ready to call
it?
Hey, if you come over here, I will kill you.
And he did just what he said he was going to do.
The sad part about that is, you know, the obvious. So you have a Caucasian woman with a pair of scissors.
Right.
That's not only...
This is on my page. If you want to check out the video, it is on my personal page, the page that we're streaming from. Be sure to check it out after the show.
Absolutely. Not only being verbally abusive, but actually has a weapon.
She had, and she was telling him...
Has a weapon. And goes at
after
officer,
him.
Right?
Several times.
Several
and
times.
If it was a person of color, they wouldn't have had that many chances.
He didn't even have to have a weapon.
Right. And so for me, her family, her cousin Melinda Peterson...
Sad.
...is saying... what the family is disputing is why they could not have used a taser instead or dummy bullets, because those dummy bullets would have knocked her down.
I almost threw up in my cup when you said that.
Well, Melinda Peterson wants to know why they didn't taser.
Why didn't Melinda say that when... Moving on.
Okay, so my sentiments exactly. So... I want to talk about something that is real, real personal to me. And I'm just going to put this card down.
Okay.
And I'm going to take me a little puff of my hookah.
Okay. Okay.
Because I'm irritated.
Okay.
Right? And I said I was going to do better and try not to curse during my show. But I need to say this. I'm irritated as fuck.
Oh.
And let me tell y'all why. We are in a time where black men, especially, I'm talking to black men, I'm talking to my community. The white men do it too. But I'm talking to the black men where they are handling us as women recklessly. And what I mean by that is I am having more black men attack me verbally or become aggressive with me verbally on social media than any time before.
Really?
And to know me is to know I don't play that shit.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? And when you deal with me, you got to deal with me in a certain way, because I'm the chick that says, good morning, queens.
Absolutely.
Good morning, kings.
That's you.
You get what I'm saying? How you doing, king?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, queen. Thank you, king. So when you deal with Tyra Hill, I can't tell you how to treat other people, but I can damn sure tell you how to deal with me. So let's go back. When I went to go interview Mayor Weaver,
yes,
I was... bullied on social media. They tried to attempt to bully me, because you know I don't go down easy. I'm rough. Derek calls me Tiger. Some people call me Tyrant. Google it. So yeah, that part. So they were upset that I was coming to Michigan. And men begin to verbally attack me. They called me a wannabe. I could not
believe. All over the election?
Not the election. Me going to interview her. The last time I went to interview
Why?
Her.
Why? What is the issue? They don't like her?
They don't like her. But evidently, my platform has power.
Evidently.
You get what I'm saying?
Evidently. Right.
See,
evidently.
You got. Sometimes you got to look at the big picture.
You do.
You see
do.
What I'm saying?
You do. And you got to be happy about it. Sometimes
but
you got to be happy about
the haters. They called me Roland Martin in the wig.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
And began to verbally attack me. So last night, or this morning, I'm strolling on Facebook, and one of my homeboys made a comment.
Are they from Michigan? Most of them?
They're all over. But the two that I'm talking about are from Michigan.
They're probably your man's minions.
Well, let me tell you the story.
We're gonna dig into that.
So what happened is, my homeboy made a post, and he said, now they're saying he's inheriting a crisis. It's going to take some time. Why are they making excuses for him? So I laughed. Right. You know, I'm petty like you.
Right.
I said, it's his turn now.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is the same thing that we saw with President Obama when number 45 came. Okay. For all of the people that hated President Obama.
Yeah. Yeah.
That talk reckless about him.
Yeah.
It was now our turn, who loved President Obama, to talk
reckless
about
your
people. Right?
And reckless about stuff like his suit.
Right.
His wife's arms are defined.
Right. I mean,
like,
birth
really?
Certificates.
I mean, this kind of reckless stuff.
Right.
That kind of
right. And so
petty
that's
reckless.
What I said. I said, it's his turn now.
Dude with a hair
now,
piece,
minding you.
Three baby mamas.
I said, baby it's baby. His turn now.
We're going to be reckless.
And so the guy came back and said something to me.
Right.
He skipped over my homeboy's status. Ain't say nothing to him.
Right.
But came
straight
down to me.
Yeah.
So the conversation would have been went a little like this. Why you saying something to me but didn't say nothing to the man that created the status?
Right.
Govern yourself accordingly, sir.
Right.
So he came back and said, I said something who I saw comment first. No. Mm. Comment on the status.
Right.
And don't say shit to me because
I
ain't say nothing to you.
Right. I'm commenting on the status, not to you.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So my problem with this is why men should never become aggressive with women. I have a whole husband that does not handle me aggressively. Now, I don't know what y'all do to y'all wives, y'all mamas, y'all sisters, y'all girlfriends, or y'all nieces, nephews. But in my family, they handle me with care. So, if, and I made a status. Mm-hmm. Dear Queens, if you ever see my husband on Facebook acting like a certified broad, arguing with a woman, going back and forth with a woman, disrespecting a woman, please hit me up immediately so I can slap the shit up out of him and embarrass him the way that he's embarrassing me.
Right.
Because it's dishonorable.
It is.
It is so dishonorable. Let me tell you something. Bernard or whoever I'm with
right.
will never have to address a woman because I got that. And not only do I have that, they know that I expect more up out of them. Men don't get into arguments with women. Men don't go back and forth with women. Another man should never address another man's wife, first and foremost.
True. That's true. That's old school, but it's true.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we got to set some order in these streets because I'm getting real irritated.
And another man
and
should not allow another man to address his wife. I mean,
so, but here's where shit can get messy. Because we're keeping it 100, right? We're talking about real life stuff, right?
Right.
Here's where shit can get messy. Because anybody that know that the men in my family don't play about me. Not only do I have a whole husband, I have a whole 27-year-old son. Not only do I have a whole 27-year-old son, I got 7 brothers.
Right.
Not only do I have a whole bunch of brothers, I got a whole bunch of cousins, a whole bunch of nephews, a whole bunch of homeboys.
Family long, as they say.
See what I'm saying? So you have to be careful on what it is that you allow to come up out of your mouth. Now, to know me is to know that I'm very strong-minded, I'm very opinionated, and I'll have a conversation with you all day as long as it's respectful.
Right.
But when you come at me sideways... So how do you feel about men interacting with women? Going back and forth. Would you ever go back and forth with a woman on social media?
There's no need to go back and forth. There's no need to go back and forth with anybody on social media, because social media is a platform where people post their opinions.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody has an opinion,
mm-hmm.
right? So if someone mm-hmm. posts a status, a picture, whatever, and someone comments on that, make a comment on the picture. If you don't like what somebody says, that's your opinion,
mm-hmm.
but you shouldn't be commenting on what somebody is saying in the comments. Comment on what the picture is and let your statement mm-hmm. be heard by those. And it should say enough that whoever's commenting can read it and understand how you feel and what mm-hmm. you mean. You shouldn't go back and forth with anyone in particular, especially not on social media.
And then you
That's
got
just
people
not grown.
Coming.
That's really for teenagers.
You got people coming for me that ain't even got no damn profile picture talking. He didn't attack you. Shut up. I don't
what
argue
mean?
With people. I don't argue with ghosts.
Scared, yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Put up a profile picture and then holler at me. You see what I'm saying? But then I just blocked y'all ass too, because while y'all being petty, I'm on my way to production.
You know, I'm a conspiracy theorist.
Mm-hmm.
You sure that ain't Mayor Weaver's, the dude that won his minions?
But they
when they see
but
y'all
they
two
support
together,
him.
That's what I'm saying.
That's
so,
what I'm saying. That's
so
why
he might
the
have
aggression
minions,
towards me.
Right, so he might have minions.
But let me tell you something.
Especially trying to get under your skin. So
whatever you feel about whatever... Be very
careful. Yeah, you got to be careful, though. Be careful.
In my Cardi B voice, be careful with me.
Be careful.
And I've asked you.
Be careful.
I've asked them before. Okay. Now I'm telling you, yeah. Be careful with me.
Be careful with anyone. You really never know who knows who and
right.
how you can be found.
Because people watching and they inboxing
absolutely.
Me. So
absolutely.
What I did, I just deleted. I mean, I didn't delete because I didn't make the status. And I said what I said.
Walk
but
right.
I just
Walk
blocked right. all of that because I'm busy. She booked. Okay? And I'll have time to go back and forth, especially not with no man. A man yeah. should never go back and forth with a woman. And I'm going to say this and I'm going to let it go.
That might not even be a man, Tyra.
No, it is, because I know his wife.
Oh, okay.
And I started to inbox her
oh,
to have
okay.
a conversation.
Okay.
But I'm going to keep
so
it
So you did
moving.
That whole research thing. You went deep on
No. Her and I, we have a good cordial relationship.
Oh.
I know his wife.
Wow.
And let me tell you something. If my husband ever disrespected her or anybody,
right.
it would be a fucking problem. A whole fucking problem.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm going to say this. We took baby to see Paw Patrol, right?
Right.
Y'all know I spoiled my grandson.
Yeah.
We VIP. We bashed out. We up in the front. So we're walking through the crowd. This woman cuts in between Bernard, me, and baby to break us up. Now, first thing going in my mind is some slick shit, because people snatching kids and my grandson fly.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Second thing going in my mind is, did this broad just do that?
Right.
So... when she tried to, we're all holding hands. So Bernard has baby's hand. Baby is in the middle, and I have his other hand. She attempted to walk in between us.
Wow.
So, and it was people everywhere. So when she did it, Bernard said, excuse you. Right?
Right.
She turned around and said, what you say? Bernard was about to say, and immediately I said,
hold up. I got you.
I pushed him back. I said, he said, excuse you. And I looked at him. I said, you don't argue with women. I got this shit.
Right. I got it.
I said, how dare you separate my grandson from his grandparents to go chase after your children? I said, you was out of pocket, but go on to your seat, because we're going to go to our seat. Immediately, I shut him down.
Right.
And like I told him, because he was pissed,
yeah.
you will never have a confrontation with a woman as long as I'm present. And even if I'm not present, you better come get me, call me, because I can pull up. Right. But you will never have a confrontation, whether it's verbal
right.
or physical, with
no,
a woman.
There's no need. There's really no need.
And so, yeah. So I wanted to talk about that. Black men, be careful with us. Watch how you talk to us, because other people are watching. Yes. And because they feel
that's
like you disrespect
thing.
Us.
That's the
they
thing.
Feel like they can disrespect us. I just had a white man call me a nigger bitch the other day.
Wow.
Because he sped up on
rock,
my tail.
Road rage.
And then stuck his finger out at me. And because I'm the chick that I am, you know what I told him? I said, you better put that fucking finger back in the window before I bite it off. And I meant that.
Road rage is the devil.
Right. And so for me, it matters on how you deal with us because they're watching you. Mm. They don't think you respect us. To them, all you call us is bitches and whores. All you do is degrade us, disrespect to us, talk down to us, be aggressive with us, be physical with us. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I need for y'all to do better.
We do. We need to do better as a community.
And women, I need for y'all to stop being so snotty and attitudinal and disrespectful as well. But I'll deal with you queens later.
That's right. And at the next show when you're doing the with the fire pit.
Oh, yeah. So I'll talk about that. We'll talk about that then. So listen, moving on. It's cuffing season.
What?
You know, are you cuffing or are you stuffing? So somebody said, what do you mean by stuffing? Are you stuffing up your love tank? You know what I'm saying? With multiple people. Are you stuffing?
Or are you cuffing up, one?
Or are you cuffing one?
It's cuffing season.
So are you a cuffer or a stuffer?
I'm a cuffer. Especially in the winter. You gotta be cuffed.
Men always want to be cuffed in the winter.
You don't want no situation where you ain't the only one, man, dude, either, because females have rosters too, mm-hmm. So you might be the only one. She
black comes. Book.
They got
a whole
book.
Look at the black book.
So yeah, this is who
today.
Season.
Today what Wednesday? Let me see who for today. That's how I used to be.
The schedule. Who's on
right.
The schedule?
Right,
schedule.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah, it's cuffing season. It's cuffing season for sure. Cause you know, dudes, we cheap. They don't want to buy multiple Christmas gifts, so they try to cut them down right
listen,
about now.
Your man about to break up with you and everything,
right.
Honey. I'm talking about
they
started,
to break up all the way
they
to sex
started arguments, right. They started arguments with you. Let me tell you, some of these ninjas, let me put you up on game, ladies. Some of these ninjas
break up till tax
will
season.
Act mad with you, start arguments with you because they got multiple women, right? So if they start an argument with you and you get mad at them, they ain't got to worry about you while they out doing whatever else they doing. Well, whoever
they
else they
don't need
they
to worry about you Thanksgiving,
right.
Christmas, or New Year's.
None of that.
Because we was beefing and we weren't together anyway. So, I'll check with you after January.
Let me put you up on
right
game.
Around tax season.
Right. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So, Derek said he's a cuffer.
I'm a cuffer. Yeah, I'm a cuffer.
Yeah.
I stay in a relationship.
Well, back in my prime, I was a stuffer.
You was a stuffer.
Hey. I had demos. I had hoes in different area codes.
Area codes. I'm in your area code.
Right.
What's up?
Be legit. I'm in your city. Would you come and scoop me?
Tyra, you crazy.
No, real talk. But yeah, so I just want to know, it's cuffing season.
Yeah, it's cuffing season.
And
we're about to have a bad winter
because
too.
It's cuffing season, do you think social media destroys relationships?
I believe if the relationship is solid, mm-hmm. that social media cannot. I believe there's nothing that can ruin a great relationship. That's an old school explanation. That means even another baby. Because you've seen old school relationships where man go out, mess around, baby, but they still stay together.
Right.
She might be on your heels even more,
right.
But she ain't leave. That's what I'm talking about. So, right. if it's that real, even
right.
though we don't really have that as much now,
mm-hmm.
but what I'm saying is, if it's that real, social media can be a huge problem.
Mm-hmm.
It can be interpreted wrong.
Well, you got disrespectful people on social media.
Absolutely.
I mean,
on both sides of the fence, though. So you might
right.
not be.
Male
like, for
and
example,
female.
You're not a disrespectful person on social media.
I try not to be, but women get intimidated by me. If
and
I
that's
say
what
hello,
I was going to get to.
If I say hello, baby, it's a problem.
Exactly.
Why she speaking
that,
to you?
Exactly.
Why she commenting on
and that's
why
what
she
I mean.
Like your
so
picture?
Interpretation. You know, people interpret things differently.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not disrespectful, but somebody might feel threatened by
right.
you. So, you know, it's really, social media can ruin a relationship.
My Cardi B
confidence
voice,
is number one.
I had chicks following me that was plotting against me for heel. Some of them still following me on social media. They probably watching now. Hey, bitch.
you You pettier than me.
I'm so petty.
You are pettier than
me. Hey, girl.
Hey, girl.
With your ugly self.
What it is.
Right. Looking like a whole smut.
Oh, Lord. We're talking to you.
We're talking to you.
Smutless.
Right. Look. You don't get no money, and you don't get no money, and you don't get no money because I get all the money.
Lord,
that was petty.
Lord, that was petty. Because she probably is white.
I know she is.
But anyway.
But anywho. But hold on real quick. Hey, girl.
You petty.
But anywho, we're moving.
Make her mad.
Right. Oh, I want her to get mad.
I don't.
But I do.
She already mad.
I'll be a huckleberry. She already mad. I want you to be mad.
You're going to make the show 2 hours.
What I got to do to make you mad?
She already mad.
I'll be your huckleberry.
She ain't getting the money, so she...
Right.
Send her a tip or something. Anyway.
But anywho, back to the Queen's wind down.
That's right.
Let me adjust my crown. See, I have ugly moments too, y'all.
It is.
Let me see what people say.
It's cuffing season.
Why they laugh?
Because you're fooling.
I have, but
you
see, said,
you
can't inspire unless you're transparent.
Absolutely.
I go through stuff just like everybody else. Life is trill for me. Life is probably more trill for me because of who I am.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yes,
and
yes.
I'm not demeaning or downplaying anything.
And that's why we talk about
through.
It, because we want you to know we're transparent.
Right, we're transparent. I go through.
Right. Believe me.
I got problems too.
Between both of these chairs, I guarantee you one of us done went through it. I guarantee it.
Absolutely.
I can almost guarantee
Experience is the best teacher. So that's why we're having real conversations.
Absolutely.
So, you know, we're running over. It's 8 o'clock. So I'm going to give us like 10 or 15 more minutes because we have to do this last thing.
All right, let's go.
So, we're going to close out the show on the question. Ooh. And we're taking calls. Cut up the ringer, Derek.
Cut it up.
Call us. I'm about to put the number in. 302-722-5857. Again, that's 302-722-5857. And the question is, how spicy or sexy is your bedroom life? And the reason why I ask is because y'all know people just talk to me, whether it's male or female. I have women emailing me telling me, you know, me and my husband or me and my guy haven't had sex in this amount of time. I think he's getting bored. Do you have any recommendations? I have men asking me, you know, I like having sex, but my wife, she's kind of a missionary chick. Missionary means, you know, just she just lay in one position. You know, Tyra, what can I do, you know, to take it to the next level? Because I don't want to cheat, right?
That's right.
And so
right.
For me, y'all know I'm an open book. I'm very transparent. I think especially if you're a wife, the Bible says that the bedroom is undefiled, which means there's nothing that you can do in your bedroom to bring shame on your intimacy or your sex life with your spouse. So, which means if you got to swing from the ceiling fan for her to get what she needs or for him to get what he needs, then y'all better get the swinging. Y'all better start being like Tarzan and Jane, right? And so, some of the other things that I would recommend. How is your bedroom life? Are you a freak?
Yeah, I'm a freak, for sure. There's no doubt about that. So,
cute, aren't you?
I'm a Kappa.
A Kappa.
I'm a Kappa. But the thing about your sex life is you need to be honest with yourself, right? Mm-hmm. And that's the biggest issue relationships have. Mm-hmm. You're not honest with yourself. Mm-hmm. And so, in turn, you can't be honest with your mate, mm-hmm. right? So, if you know you need a certain thing or position, when you initially feel that urge, that like I want to be in a relationship with this person, you need to let them know. If they haven't done it to that point, you need to let them know.
You gotta let them know your love language. Not just verbally, but sexually.
Sexually.
What's your love language?
You have to let them know your love language.
But in all fairness, as women, our body changes. After we have babies, we go through menopause.
It does.
So as women, sometimes it's medical more than just physical.
And if it does, and if there is a change, we always talk about it. Communication is the key. And be aware, as a man, when you communicate these things to your significant other, maybe a female, male, or whatever, that person is initially not going to take that statement in a in a good light, right? Mm-hmm. They're gonna feel like you're attacking them. Mm-hmm. But what you want to do is you want to get it out anyway. Mm-hmm. So don't take it, offensive. Or take it as an attack on yourself because mm-hmm. they're gonna come back and say something to you, right? Mm-hmm. So if I'm in a relationship with somebody and say, you know what, I really need. Every now and again, I just need you to be upside down. It's just something about you upside
face down,
down, face
ass
down,
up.
Ass. I just need when I come home, you face down, ass up. Well, immediately that you said what you needed, right? Okay, mm-hmm. and that's the thing, communication. So believe me, they heard you. But the next thing that person will say is, "Well, some days I need you to lick my coochie a little more." And you know, that's just the nature of, right. of conversation, right?
Because it's give and take.
It's give
compromise.
And take. So now right. that you said it, the person is going to now say something. And even though you feel as though you've done enough, they're going to want you, you know, just do a little more. But they're going to have something to say.
Well, this
just
is my problem
absorb
with
that.
Men. This is my problem with men.
What is that?
My problem with some men is that when you try to convey to them that the sex life isn't working for you, mm-hmm. they get not intimidated, their pride takes over. And so my thing to men is, if she's telling you it's not working for her and this is what you need to do to turn her on or to take her there, mm-hmm. because most women haven't even had an orgasm. Sorry to say, ladies, y'all ain't
that, and that is a so true.
Right.
So
most
true
women haven't even experienced the orgasm.
And you don't even know what you're sitting there saying, yes, I have.
Right.
And you really
right,
have.
And you really have.
You're just busting nut.
Right.
You have not.
Right.
You have not had an orgasm. You thought you did.
Right.
You just
yes,
I did.
Good.
It felt good. Yes,
right.
I did. I had an orgasm yesterday.
And so when you try to tell your significant other from a woman's perspective what it is that you need to get you to that elevation, to take you there, and that pride get in the way, I need for my brothers to start listening to the women just as much as I need the women to start listening to the brothers.
Absolutely.
So here's the thing. I'm going to close out the show on some good notes. I'm going to give you some tips, ladies. And Derek, I'm going to give a tip. You're going to give a tip. I give a tip to the ladies. You give a tip to the men.
Okay.
So, like Derek said, if you're used to having, I asked the question, mm-hmm. what's your golden time of the day? I said morning sex is great. Mm-hmm. But I'm the chick, you can hit it or get it whenever you want it or whatever you like, right?
Okay.
I'm the chick, the wife, the girlfriend, and the mistress that's going to probably come to your job. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and speaking to the mic. You get what I'm saying? Or book a hotel room. Mm. Put on a wig that I wouldn't. That's not my hair color. Red, blonde, oh, maybe purple, maybe blue. Send him a text message. Tell him where I am, the room that I am. Have him a key left at the front desk. I might be in the tub. Hell, I might be in this, and then you can tell your.
You might be in what?
I might be in this.
Oh, hell.
My door slam love swing. Yes! Just waiting. So, yeah, you have to invest into things. Derek, I think my gummy panties just fell.
Girl.
My apple gummy panties just fell. So, Derek, this is my first tip.
Okay.
Invest. Go to novelty stores. Invest into sex toys.
Gummy
and I got some other stuff to show you. Derek, what's your tip?
My tip for the gentleman is this.
Okay, look into the camera.
Foreplay does not have to be physical. So
break it down. What you mean, bro?
I'm about to break it down. About to break it
break
down.
It break it down. Down.
As Mark would say, break it down. Break
wicked, 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 wicked.
But foreplay does not have to be physical. So... Mm-hmm. You can prepare your significant other for a great night by doing small little teeny things mm-hmm. that you normally don't do. So
mm-hmm.
there are some men that are booty squeezers, like B is a booty squeezer, right? If you're not normally a butt squeezer, mm-hmm. squeeze that ass. Squeeze that ass. Right?
Look into the camera, say it again.
Squeeze that ass, right? If you're not a nipple puller, one day she, you know, you thinking about doing something late on the night, you're leaving for work, pull that titty out, suck that titty. Right?
Well, wait a minute.
Suck
you give
titty.
It to me. I said one.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, they all together.
He
that,
ain't got.
That,
but
so,
since you're talking about the nipple,
so,
ladies, this right here
what is
the nipple. You
what?
Put it on your nipple,
don't
and your man
my...
gets to, your man gets to twist it. Ooh, mm. He fell out. Yeah, he gets to twist it, but it, you know, it's
it
a.
It pulls on your nipple.
Yeah, it pulls on your nipple. Right.
So you bought something that your hands could do.
Well, kind of, sort of. But yeah, so it's like two of these.
And you just leave that on the nipple.
And while you're on top, ladies, your guy can twist these.
Twist those on your nipple.
Yeah. Right? Okay, go ahead, Dad.
You gotta sterilize those that
Well, I mean, they like your titties licking milk.
Absolutely.
But go ahead, Derek.
So, gentlemen, tip number two is sometimes be more spontaneous.
Or your breasts. Your
breasts, yeah. Yeah, sometimes you have to be more spontaneous, even on those tired days. So, mm-hmm. some days, you know, it depends on what a man does. You need to be spontaneous. Like Tyra says, she's the wife, the mistress, the lover,
girlfriend,
all of that. And you have to be that
side
person.
Chick,
you have to be that
the
person.
Stalker.
Too. So, you know, a lot of times men that cheat, there's something mysterious about.
But let's talk about that.
About the cheating.
Because Niecy Nash.
And that's what drives the cheat.
Niecy Nash is about to get divorced. She just made an announcement, her and her husband. Yeah. And Niecy Nash was the chick that said a blowjob a day will make the man stay. Only thing that's going to keep a man, ladies, is a man that want to be kept. I don't
that's
give
right.
a.
That's true.
I was about to say something real harsh. I don't care how much head you give him, how much vagina you give him, how much you cook, how much you clean.
That's right.
A man will cheat on you if he's not happy within himself. You could be doing all the right things
that's
with
right.
the wrong man.
Yep.
It's not your fault. Shit happens. You're not the first woman to be cheated on. You're not going to be the last one to be cheated on. Yep. Just make sure that you stay dope for you.
That's
so
right.
with that being said, I love these.
What's that?
My gummy panties. They green apples. They edible crotchless panties.
That's right.
Like you can flirt with your man.
And women, I'll also say this on top of what Ty was saying. When you do find a man that truly loves you and shows you that he loves you, you need to be, don't get complacent. Do
mm-hmm.
not.
That's what happens. People get comfortable.
Don't get
men
comfortable.
Men get comfortable too.
Because the minute you get comfortable is the minute that man is going to want seek something else. Especially a man that truly, truly loves a kid. Keep that man interested by doing the same things. Do not get complacent and think, well, okay, he's all right with the missionary. My coochie gets so wet or whatever the case may be. That after a while.
50 Shades of Grey me.
After a while, that may bore him as well. So,
50
you know,
Shades of Grey me. 50 Shades of Grey me. And what I mean by this, ladies,
shades.
You got to turn it up a notch. Get you some masks.
You do.
Get you some sexy masks like this. 50 Shades. A red lip is always appropriate.
Talk to
black
your,
panties.
Talk to your significant other about fantasies. Don't be scared to talk about fantasies. Don't be scared to talk about the past, right? The past is exactly that. It's the past.
Right.
You can't change it.
What's your fantasy? Do
you know,
want
have
to be...
Have you had your fantasy?
Right.
Be honest.
And
if you have,
to
say yes.
Be open and honest with
be
your
honest.
Partner to let them know.
Yeah, be honest.
This right here is a control to some panties. Ladies, I would give my man this. I have gifted my man this. Their panties, you put them on, maybe you're going out for dinner, cocktails, maybe he's taking you out for dancing, you give him the remote all night long, he's zapping it, you on a date, you up, so by the time you walk up out the restaurant, he can hit it in the car. I'm just saying, I'm giving y'all some ideas, okay?
These are great ideas. Gentlemen, these are great ideas for us.
So
we need to be buying
Derek,
these things.
Go ahead, Derek, before I give, because two more.
All right, so this is the last one for me, and this is going to be in reference, a little more serious, but this is in reference to sexuality and how right now a lot the black men are being attacked in regards to our masculinity,
mm-hmm.
you know, the thing with Tank and whatever. What's good for you is what's good for you, right? If that's good, I don't know Tank, but if that's what turned Tank's on,
that's what you get when you're fucking with me.
If that's what turned Tank's on, that's him.
We're
right?
gonna have a talk.
So
we're gonna have a conversation.
So you
about
need
that.
To be as
that's
honest as you can be. But females, please don't try to. Demasculate.
Men don't want you playing
exactly.
back
and
there.
Don't want you, and you need to have that conversation with a
right.
man. Don't think because I saw it on social media, my girlfriend said her boyfriend liked it,
right.
that
it
your man liked
everybody.
It. Because that could start a whole war or something else.
Right.
So don't do that.
Right, and fellas, just don't assume that your girl is going to be into something
in
just
something,
because
yeah.
another chick
did that.
Have those
right.
hard conversations.
Have those hard conversations.
You like to be spanked?
Not at all.
You know, I'm dominating.
Well, you can dominate somebody else. I'm freaky. I'm not that freaky.
You like to be spanked. Yes, just little love things. I have two more things. My other things are right here.
In the immortal words of my friend.
These are called F me dice, sex me dice. And on the dice, you can't see them. It says lips, earlobes, places you have to kiss, lips, nipple, you roll these, navel, you lick, shower sex, receive oral sex, doggy style, woman on top, side by side sex. So yeah, you just kind of, you know, shoot them dice. Y'all know what to do. Hold on, let me show y'all. Hey! Oh, so you gotta kiss my cheek. Mm. Man on top. Spank me.
Oh.
And spank my butt cheeks. So, yeah. Last but not least. 50 Shades of Grey.
That's 50 Shades of Grey right there. That's a whole felony right there. I don't want nothing to do with that. That's a felony. Because I may not hear you say no. Kinda. That's when somebody's saying no and you still saying hell yeah.
You gotta have a safe word.
Safe word.
So you gotta have a safe word. And I'm just trying to put y'all on game. So you have things that go here. Your hands. Tie your feet up. And yeah, that. So, ladies, don't say T-Hill didn't teach you and she didn't spill the tea. These Derek, are important. You got one last thing you
want to
say?
For the gentleman,
mm-hmm.
Another thing, gentlemen, and I've heard this many, many times, and we've all heard this. It's a mistake to ask your significant other if they're interested in having a threesome. If that's something you're interested in, you need to let her come out and say that. Because if you ask that of your significant other, they're going to feel, some, I'm not saying all, nothing is for all. But some women feel inferior, like you need someone else in the bedroom, or you're interested in somebody mm-hmm. else. So if that's something that you're interested in, number one, I would have that hard conversation. If mm-hmm. that's something you were into when you were single, have that hard conversation before you get into a relationship. Look, I was really into threesomes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what I did when I was single. I really enjoy you. But would you be upset if I were to invite someone else? She might like her.
And let me say this. Y'all invite somebody into your relationship, be prepared for whatever consequences is going to take place.
Bing, 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 bing.
Because
bing.
It happens.
Derek, all the time.
I want to say, whatever type of sex you decide to have, whatever type of energy you have in your bedroom, make sure that you protect yourself.
Absolutely.
Especially sexual transmitted.
If you're married, mm-hmm. then that's different. But if you're single, mm-hmm. dating, yeah,
STD
I know paperwork.
Rate, STD rate is high.
And higher and more mm-hmm. in certain cities. So mm-hmm. if you're a player that travels in other area codes,
mm-hmm.
you have to be aware of everything. You should definitely be strapped up at all times. But, you know, you don't want to go D.C. playing around. I'm just saying.
Well, not or only Atlanta. That, men. And we're going to have, because we're going to talk about Tank.
Mm-hmm.
Men. Mm. If you like men, sex men.
Sex men.
Stop playing with these women.
Stop playing with women.
Stop
or,
being these
or be
undercover.
Real about it.
Be real about it.
Let
the woman decide if she wants to be a
Absolutely.
Part of that. I had a great time today.
I did too. Shout out
did
to
Did y'all have a great time? Shout out to who?
The speaking of men, mm-hmm. women and men,
mm-hmm.
I watched Love and Hip Hop, I think it's Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And this dude on it is Zell.
Who was
as transparent as possible.
Bisexual.
He's bisexual. Mm-hmm. You know, he likes men, but he wants to settle down with a woman.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have a problem with a man that's transparent. Don't just be out here ghosting or, you know,
got a whole wife at home.
Got a whole wife
at home. But got a whole boyfriend somewhere else.
No, don't do that.
Not cool.
It's not fair.
Not cool.
To everyone involved and all of us out here.
Guys, it's been real. Did you enjoy the show today? If you enjoyed the show, give me the hearts.
And if you think it should be 2 hours, give us some hearts.
Give me some hearts. If you missed last week's, please visit the Tyra Hill Show YouTube channel. Be sure to subscribe. It is also on our website, thetyrahillshow.com. If you have not connected with us on social media, do that. Instagram, that's IG, baby, the Tyra Hill Show. Twitter, @TyraHill.
Ow.
Facebook, This is my personal Facebook page that we're streaming from, but it's the Tyra Hill Show page and my public figure, Tyra Hill page. Derek Marcano is on Facebook. We had such a great conversation on tonight. Don't forget to get with your Congressional Black Caucus leaders that I named.
Look at the heart. Tell them. Boom, boom, boom.
Tell
we love
them.
Y'all.
I love you guys so much. Y'all. Tell them that you want them to be a part of the Brian Allen movement against Comcast.
Yes.
We need your voice to be heard again.
Yes. Yes.
Congratulations to every.
To every delegate congressman out there and the congressman from the Black National
Congressional Black Caucus.
Yes, we need them to hurry up and get their voting. It ain't about your popularity.
And shout out to the female mayor in Compton.
In Compton, second term.
Yes.
Youngest mayor ever in Compton. Shout out to her.
Black excellence, the dream still demands.
And I will say it again, black women, y'all run the world.
Derek always says that.
Y'all say it all the time.
Be sure.
Y'all run the world.
To tune in next Wednesday, same time, same place. Next week, I'm doing a bonfire with my sister girls. Mm. We're going to be around the fire talking sisterhood, why women are catty, why women can't get along, and what we need to do as sister girls to be the new norm.
We gotta let that go viral. We need to really, really, really.
I'm excited about next week's show.
That's
I'm really
huge.
Excited
That's
about
huge.
That.
That information is, because women run the world.
Right.
I want y'all to get together and run this world.
Right.
I do.
So I love you guys. Whatever you do, stay up, stay blessed, and we're closing out on this one. Peace and blessings to you.
Give us some hearts.
Who, Derek? Who was twerking today?
I'm just saying, if you're a real good twerker, you can twerk.
Give us some hearts. We love you.
We love y'all. Stay up, stay blessed. And let's talk about
it. Great show.
You ain't even look. I'm almost finished.
Hey.
Ain't this what you came for?
Yes, it is.
Don't you wish you came more?
Yes, I do.
Girl, what you playing for?